Assalamualaikum, my name is Mehmood Sajid and you are watching Introduction of Biology with Mehmood Sajid. Today we start a new topic, that is cell cycle, in which today we study about the cell cycle and the four phases, which are G1 phase, S phase, G0 phase and the G2 phase. Before starting the lecture, if you are new on my channel, please subscribe to my channel so you can get my latest videos. So let's go to the screen.
First, we study about the cell cycle. That what is cell cycle? Cell cycle is the series of event. It starts from when a cell is produced until it completes mitosis and produces new cells. This whole paragraph is the definition of cell cycle. If you write this paragraph, whole paragraph in definition, then you take 2 marks. Now study the major two phases of cell cycle. First phase is interphase and the second phase is mitotic phase. Mitotic phase is relatively short period in cell cycle, but the interphase is it takes in 90% time, spend this 90% time in interphase. In mitotic phase, cell relatively short period of cell cycle, then cell spends 10% only 10% its time in mitotic phase. In 90% cell spends time in interphase. Interphase is the time when a cell metabolic is very high, as it performs various function that we study in this video. It is divided into 3 phases. First phase is interphase, second phase is S phase, first phase is also G1 phase, is also called first grab. Second phase is S phase, which is also called synthesis. And the last phase is G2 phase, which is also called second gap. But we study about G0 phase after G1 phase. First we study about the G1 phase, that is also called first gap. G1 phase. I write G1 phase in point that you easily understand the definition and the topic of G1 phase. That the cell increases its supply of protein during cell cycle. First point is cell increases supply of protein in cell cycle. Cell increases supply of protein increases in cells. The second point is that the cell increases number of organelles. Cell increases number of organelles. We study about the organelles in detail in our previous chapter, that is chapter number 4. Organelles like mitochondria, ribosome, Golgi apparatus, endoplasm, reticulum. And the third point is that the cell grown in size. Cell during the interphase, G1 phase, first gap, cell increases in size. The fourth function is that, and the last function that occur in G1 phase is that the cell size, cell increases the various enzymes. Cell increases the various enzymes. This is the G1 phase. In book, the next phase is S phase, but in real, the next phase is G0 phase. That what is G0 phase? G0 phase in multicellular eukaryotes, cell enter in G0 phase from G1 phase. The book also telling that the cell enters G0 phase from G1 phase and stop dividing and taking rest. But in this, there's also the categories that whose cells remain indefinite, enters in G0 phase or indefinite for semi-permanently or for not enters in G0 phase. First, we study that cells remain in G0 phase for indefinite period. That some cells enter in G0 phase for indefinite period, means for the cells to stop dividing and forever and never again start dividing. Like neuron cells, these cells enters in G0 phase for indefinite period. The second category is that some cells enter G0 phase for semi-permanently time, means that the cells stop dividing for some time like some cells of liver and kidney. And the third and the last category is that many cells do not enter the gene or phase and continue to divide like epithelial cells. The next phase is S phase. That is very small. In S phase, there is a small function that the chromosomes are duplicate. This is a function that in S phase, cell duplicates its chromosomes. As a result, each chromosome consists of two chromatid. We study about the chromatid in our next lectures. That what is chromatid. The last phase is G2 phase, which is also called second gap. What is G2 phase? The G2 phase, after this phase, cell enter in mitotic phase. In G2 phase, cell prepares protein that are essential for mitosis. Means that the cell prepares protein for the production of spindle fibers. That what is spindle fibers. We study about the spindle fibers in our next lecture. That is about mitosis. Spindle fiber is used in mitosis. After G2 phase, cells enter in M phase, which is also called and mitotic phase. After the G2 phase of interphase, the last phase of interphase is G2 phase. Cell enter the division phase, which is M phase, which is also called mitotic phase. It is categorized by mitotic phase, in which cell divide into two daughter cells. In next lecture, we study about the daughter cells, two daughter cells, how they divide into two daughter cells. So the real cell divide in mitotic phase, in which cell is completely divided. So the next lecture is very important. So please don't miss the next lecture. This is the diagram of phases of interphase. There are four phases. First is G1 phase, G0 phase, S phase. They're not telling the about the G0 phase because many cells do not enter G0 phase. This is the G1 phase. We study about the functions of G1 phase. This is the S phase, in which cell duplicated chromosomes. This is G2 phase and this is the M phase. We study about the M phase, means mitotic phase. We study about the mitotic phase in our next lecture. So that's all. This is the diagram of mitotic phase.
That's all. Our today's lecture is finished. If you like my video, please like it. And if you have any query about this topic, please tell me on comment. Once again, if you are new on my channel, please subscribe to my channel so you can get my latest videos. So, we'll meet on the next lecture. Till then, Allah Hafiz.